Hi, Eaglemont family. I received a letter this week, as every other pastor in our Pentecostal Assemblies Fellowship did, from our PAOC International Missions Director, Murray Cornelius. And I want to share a synopsis of that letter regarding the current situation in many of the countries that our mission-focused fellowship is working in. Many of you know that as a church family, we, Eaglemont, we support and actively engaged in supporting missions, and that's exciting and eternal stuff. Murray wrote this exciting statement in his letter. He said, "Over the past number of months, despite the change in how we live the mission of Jesus, we have heard testimonies from around the world of hundreds coming to Christ. We see God moving," and that's awesome. He also shared how impressed he's been with our PAOC global workers and international partners for their creativity and their perseverance during this unprecedented time of trying to do ministry and outreach and missions in new ways. And by the way, because it's PAOC does not mean it's better. It just means it's family that we're a part of, and we're just one part of the vineyard in the work of sharing the gospel of Jesus in our world. And I love that our church has a heart for missions, and that's close to God's heart, of course. Murray also shared how many Canadian churches have sacrificed to honor their commitment to our global workers, and how the missions arm of the PAOC has made budget adjustments for sure, and continues to trust God for provision. But it was awesome to read that not a single PAOC global worker has had to return to Canada due to a lack of finances in these months. When I heard that, I immediately thought of the faithful giving from many of you. God bless you for that. Murray's letter was, one of the purposes was to draw attention to the vulnerable in many non-resourced countries that we're ministering in. He spoke of pastors and people in various places who are struggling daily to meet their basic needs of enough food and the living expenses for their families. You may be interested to know that Eaglemont Pastors Council recently approved and gave a $1,300 donation from our church's what we call Winds of the Spirit fund to help get a container of food supplies to the Dominican Republic, where Trent and Rhonda Lipinski, global workers that Eaglemont supports, where they will help distribute that food to neighborhoods in connection with local churches in various regions there in the DR. It's cool to be a part of that. Anyway, the need is great worldwide, but as we all do what God wants us to do, the need can be met. And Murray expressed that he has felt the Spirit of God leading him to do something tangible for believers and for our ministry colleagues around the world who are suffering and lacking what they need right now as a result of this pandemic. And is actually mentioning that so many of them were in dire situations prior to COVID. So he said that this Saturday, August 1st, he will be doing a 100-kilometer bike ride to raise financial support for our family of believers around the world that are lacking these basic necessities these days. And I wanted to mention that if you want to support, you can go to paoc.org and click on the International Missions button, and then scroll down a little and you'll see a picture of Murray with his bike and the words Ride to Thrive. And click on that, and then you'll see to the left, make a donation button on that webpage. I invite you to join me and Miriam in doing this. And if it's easier for you, you can email me and I'll send you the link. I know that for many in Canada, there are challenges as well. It's expensive to live here, and the economic difficulties have hit very close to home for some of you, or have hit your home, your family. And by the way, if that's the case for you, or for someone you know in your neighborhood, please let us know. We want to do what we can to help. So I wanted you to hear our missions director's comments and what he is doing personally. I see this as a great example for all of us. God might lead you to do something for some good purpose to help others in a time like this that's unique. And so for those who are able and feel God's leading to share, specifically in this opportunity financially, this is a trusted way to do it. So I want to pray right now for people in under-resourced countries particularly, or those that are lacking. Pray with me, and maybe you're among them, and this prayer is for you. And so I pray, Heavenly Father, that by your Spirit you would bring encouragement and hope, as well as practical needs met in the lives of people who are lacking and maybe even destitute and wondering where they will get the next loaf of bread or a container of milk. God, you're able to provide in your own creative ways, but we know that you'll also use us. And so those that are able, may we respond as you lead us to help and share and encourage others with a generous heart. We give you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.